Welcome. In this module, we will see how to implement workload management. On your Redshift management console, select the parameter group and workload management. Then you'll get an option to add a queue. Make a note, it is not available on free tier. So once you add that queue, your queue will get created as shown in the image. Then you can enter the parameters like concurrency of that group and user group. Here you can enter user group as ETL star. Star means wildcard. So any user group which starts with ETL will be accepted here. And you can check the option of match wildcards to match the wildcard. And you have query groups and session timeout and memory percent. You can run this query. I may provide this in the comments below as well or in the description. When you run this query, you will get the information about the query groups, their number of available slots, memory, and other information. Even this service class query will give the query groups. Here it will give a service class and it will give all the query queues, which are system queues, like health check, metrics collection, all are system queues. So this table is to analyze the distortion key or sort key or encoding techniques used inside a column, size of the table, and few other parameters which will be helpful to identify the skewness in a table or so on. I will provide this query in the comments below, and you can use this on a table or in your existing data warehouse to identify the distribution keys, sort keys or encoding techniques, or if there is any skewness and size of your blocks. Thank you.